Indeed, my Chromatogos Scalaris is going to explode in numbers. Watch this video until the end to see their massive growth. This Chromatogos colony has been nothing but crazy, and they even tried to escape. In this video, we will talk about the colony and show you their progress. But first, a recap of what happened with this colony so far. This Chromatogos colony is now a little over a year old, and they came to me as a single queen. They did pretty bad at the start. It took ages before the first workers arrived, and I did not think they would make it. But then, the first workers arrived and everything was good. Later, a second worker arrived and that was even better. Then, a week later, one worker died, and that got me pretty worried. Luckily, the ants had a good brood pile, so it seemed alright. More workers hatched and the ball started rolling. The ants kept doubling in workers, and eventually it became too hard to feed them inside a mini outworld. So, what I did was move the ants into a medium outworld and started a tubs and tubes setup. In this setup they did very well, and it did not take too long for the colony to reach 100 workers. For a long period of time I thought these ants were going to be the largest colony with the speed in which they grew, but that did not happen. The medium outworld did its job, but after placing in a second tube, it was time to relocate these ants. The colony moved into an acrylic nest pretty fast. They did very well inside this nest. How well exactly? Well, let me show you. The colony went from 100 workers to 500 workers. Insane, right? I'm not sure it's exactly 500, but that is what my estimate is on how many ants there are in this colony. It is absolutely crazy to see these numbers of ants, and do you see that brood pile? The brood pile is absolutely crazy, and every time I look there's fresh brood everywhere. The queen is pumping out egg after egg, and soon this colony will explode. With the growth of Chromatogos Scalaris, the first problems will most likely start to occur. The first problems have already started. One of them is space. The outworld is too small. But giving them a large extra outworld seems a bit overkill to me. One extra problem is that I accidentally wiped off the Fluon barrier. The ants know this and they know now how to escape. That's why I decided to do the following. Recently I got my own Fluon, that is also available in the store. The stuff I tested so far worked great, so I'm going to test it on these Skittles as well. First, I smeared the Fluon on a new outworld using these applying sponges. Then, I connected the new outworld to the old one. That's right, two separate outworlds. I'm going to try and see how the ants will behave. I don't think it will matter one bit. With the second outworld attached, it did not take too long before the ants rushed in. This was the perfect time to feed them. So, I put in some rat runners and a liquid feeder with sugar water and plain water. Sadly, some Scalaris workers drown inside the liquid feeders, but it's not a huge number and it hardly slows down this colony. Here is some footage of the ants drinking and eating. Also some footage from the ants inside this nest. You can see a lot of yellowish stuff inside the nest. That is the honey jelly the ants took inside the nest. I have no idea why they did it. I have also no idea why the ants don't occupy the whole nest, but keep themselves in a confined space. If you have a clue why, tell me in the comments. Enjoy this final footage of the ants. Thank you for watching. I'll see you next time.